Hey guys, I got something else to talk to you about here, and that's game remakes, what I think about them overall. Now, I'm not specifically talking about the HD, so-called HD collection remake ones, the remasters that they've been doing a lot lately. I just mean remaking games in general, something that came out before however many years ago, and then they re-release it, remake it, or they change it in some way, that kind of thing. Now, there usually is only two ways this goes. Either someone really likes it a lot, even if it's a game that is their favorite, and you wouldn't think that they'd be okay with it that way. It all depends. And then there are some who really do not like it, and they kind of despise it and wish they never did it and refuse to even acknowledge it. I've seen that kind too. Now, me personally, I'm kind of in between. I'm fine with it for the most part, because, well, yeah, it is something I've played before, probably for a very long time, many times, and I know it in and out. But sometimes getting a new coat of paint on something that you are very familiar with is actually a really good thing, and is kind of enough to get you back into it or playing it again. Kind of gets your interest back into it if you kind of lost it, you know what I mean? Or it also can go another way where it'll just look better these days anymore because it didn't really hold up that well. That's more of the visuals. But then here's a good example, Resident Evil Remake for the first one on the GameCube. Now, I used to have and played the first one on the PlayStation, and then I got the GameCube remake. Wasn't so sure about it at first. I thought it was just going to be the same exact game, only with better visuals or whatever else, or maybe they just changed everything completely. I wasn't so sure about it. I didn't think it was going to be any good. But then I got it. And I was really impressed and surprised with how well they did it. Not only did they recreate the feeling and the way the game played of the original, the PlayStation I was familiar with, but they also did enough new things to it to make it feel a little bit, not the same thing you've already done over and over, but they didn't change too much to it where it ruined the game. And I think that's the most important thing with this, and I think that's the thing that they should be making their priority, to be honest with you. Because with this whole remake thing, obviously what you're doing is you are directly going for the audience of the original. That's what your target demographic is. That's who you're trying to sell this game to. Say if you remade the original Gex game, what you were really going to be doing is trying to market that to the people who like the original, who were into the original or that series, not so much newer people getting into the series. So if you at least make sure that you make the game like what the original was, and you don't change so much about it that it seems like a completely different thing, and then you're going to throw the people who like the original one off, and you're going to just draw their ire, you know what I mean? And they're not going to want anything to do with it, so there's a good chunk going. If you can get that right, if you can make it pretty much the same as like the original one is without changing everything about it, because then it's not even a remake, this might as well be just a completely redone game, you know what I mean? Then that's good. It's kind of like Black Mesa for the first Half-Life. Again, here's another example. They took the first Half-Life, which is a really good first-person shooter. They brought it into more recent times. They updated the visuals. They use a more recent version of the Source engine. They also changed a few things, not everything entirely, so it doesn't feel like the original Half-Life, but they updated it, improved some things, gave it better visuals. Stuff like that, but they also did change some things, but didn't change everything about it. And that's the thing I like with remakes. I don't want it to change everything about it. It needs to have the feeling and play like what the original one did. I'm not saying exactly just take the original one, slap a new coat of paint on it and visuals or whatever, update the graphics and make new textures and crap and just spit it out there. Not like that. You gotta have it feel like the original. And, the people like, say, if they wanted to remake the first Doom. You got to make it feel like the first one. It's got to play like the first one, and it's got to work for people like me that like it, because we're the ones that are going to be going for it. And it doesn't stomp on the original. You know what I mean? You're just kind of reinvigorating it. You're giving it new life. You're not trying to remake it entirely. You're not trying to change what it was because you didn't like the way the original one came out. I've seen some remakes that do that. I've seen a few remakes where they completely changed almost every single thing about it to the point where it doesn't even resemble what the original game was. And there are some that kind of do it half and half like that, where they didn't go that far, but they went far enough where it's not very recognizable from what the original one is, or in some cases, with one I'm thinking of particularly, it's not even the same genre. So that's very different. The one I'm thinking of course, is Syndicate, which came out, what was it, in 2011? Now, it's not a horrible game. It's a pretty average first-person shooter. It's not that bad. It's just really short, and it's mainly focused on co-op. It's okay. It's not that bad. I've played it. But it doesn't really resemble what the original one was, the original Syndicate. I know, especially because I played the original. And that's a strategy game. It's a top-down isometric RTS. Going from that to a first-person shooter already, you've kind of really jarred a lot of people and not what they were expecting. In fact, I still remember reading a lot of people were kind of upset about that, that why are you taking a game that we've been waiting for so many years for either a sequel or a proper remake of, and you turn it into a first-person shooter? Some people were really, really up in arms about that, you know? And I can see why, because some people, they really like a lot of these games and they don't want it messed with. And that's the problem, I think, with some of these remakes, is they don't do that. However, but this is the good thing. For the most part, a lot of these remakes do get it right. Or if they do change a lot of it, they do it in a way where even if it might not even be the same type of game as it was originally, it still resembles what that one is and has the same feeling to it. Here's another example. Last night, in fact, the last day of the Steam sale, I missed it a lot. I used to have it for the PlayStation 3, and it was on a really good deal. So I wanted to get XCOM Enemy Unknown, because I really like the original XCOM, too. I'm a big fan of that. But it also came bundled with The Bureau XCOM, which is a third-person shooter, which is essentially a prequel. I'll probably do a video on it eventually talking about it. And while it's not exactly what you would call, like, XCOM, which is a strategy game, again, there's kind of the same thing coming back. Instead, it's a third-person shooter, but it has strategy elements to it. You know, you can command your allies and units around and stuff like that, strategy your teammates. So it's got a little bit of an XCOM thing to it in that regard, but it also has the same themes going through it, has the same feel to it, has the same kind of setting. If you do that, it works out well, and that works, you know? You can have the kind of game that you want to make a remake of, but you can change some things to it enough where it is kind of a different game, but you're still going to appeal to the people who like the original one. You know what I mean? It's kind of a long explanation, but I think you get what I'm trying to explain with this. And that's the way I like it myself. When you take a game that is well-known, whether it's one, you know, me or someone else, and you change some things to it, to give it a little bit of new life, you know, bring it into more recent times, and you make it look a little bit better than what it did originally, you know, and things like that. That is a good way of doing it. You'll make the people who like the original one happy, they'll be willing to get it, and you could probably even get some newer people into it, because remember this, and here's another part to this, and this is also why it's important to focus on making the remake much like the original, but not in every single way, is that some people might want to play the original one because they hear about it and they see it, but they're just not willing to because maybe they don't like playing it because it looks older or the mechanics are kind of outdated, but they'll play the remake because it kind of changes some of those problems. I've seen that too, and I've had that happen with a few games I've played where I didn't really care for the original one that much, but the remake I actually kind of liked a lot, you know? It's sometimes hit and miss. They don't always work out, like Turok in 2008, that one, which is just called Turok, didn't really work out as well as they were hoping for, and I was looking really forward to the I was very much looking forward to the multiplayer, one of the few times I was, actually, and then comes out and it's not exactly as amazing as you thought it would be, and you kind of still prefer to play the original Turok, you know what I mean? It's kind of like that, you know? Here's another example. They came out with a GoldenEye remake, and this is the last way I'll say this and end it. They came out with a GoldenEye remake on the GameCube. The Wii. The first Wii. The GoldenEye remake on the Wii. I had it. It's fairly decent, you know? It's pretty good. It's fun using motion controls in it, too. But a lot of people still preferred the original GoldenEye on the N64. And you can kind of see why in some ways, because while it is a first-person shooter, they did change a lot of things too, and it felt a little bit more like Call of Duty than it did GoldenEye, whereas you have things like Time Splitters, that series feels a lot more like GoldenEye than the GoldenEye remake does in many ways. You know, it's kind of like that. It's like a fine balance you have to get, but if you can get that kind of stuff right, it'll work out well. And that's the kind of thing I like with remakes, you know? So, when you can give it new life, but you don't change everything to it, and it still feels like what the original one did enough, I think that's enough. And to me, it always has been. That's kind of a reason why I like XCOM Enemy Unknown so much, because while it might not be 100% exactly like the original XCOM, it still feels like the original XCOM. It still has the same themes to it, and it still has the same gameplay to it, mostly, you know? That's the kind of thing I like. You can change some things to it, but don't change everything. That's when I'm not really that willing to go for it, at least me personally. So this is basically all I think about remakes and how the way I like it when they do it that way and not So there you go. It's a little kind of rambling, long thing, but there you go. Maybe you'll find it interesting. So, of course, as always, feel free to say what you think about this or do a video response or whatever you want to do. So that's it. That's what I think about video game remakes overall in general. That's it. Thanks for watching and listening, and I will see you later.